Drink your protein, ladies and gentlemen. Drink your protein. This is just a self-care reminder. A lot of you have recognized in the comments down below that I have some bags under my eyes. I haven't been getting much sleep. This is the product of doing three reviews at once, but I've been trying to sleep more, at least 8 hours a night. I've been using eye cream so I look a little more presentable on camera, hopefully over time. I thank you guys for caring about me. So I just want to go ahead and return the message. Eat well, sleep well, exercise, take good care of yourselves. I appreciate you guys reaching out to me. But now, let's get into it, starting off with the Mass Effect Trilogy Remaster. I'm getting used to using my microphone like this, by the way. I keep, like, making out with it and stuff, and I'm really trying not to, but this is how you're supposed to use it, apparently. Yeah, I know, I'm really good at my job. I just figured that out. Anyway, today we're once again talking about the Mass Effect Trilogy Remaster, and you guessed it, the source is the Grubhub. I've really beat that joke into the ground. I'm sorry. I thought it was funny at first, but, like, I also didn't anticipate talking about it this much, and I can only produce jokes so quickly, so we're sticking with it. But, yep, Jeff Grubb at it again, giving us more Mass Effect Trilogy Remaster information. BioWare's horribly kept secret. And I don't know if this is like a positive update or a bad update. It's just another really big update. Like, there's a lot of information to go over, more so than our last couple of news videos, to be quite honest with you. So this information is coming from a Eurogame article. I'll have it linked in the description down below if you'd like to check it out for yourself. But we're going to be going over all the information within that article in today's video. So get cozy and let's talk about Mass Effect once more. Now, however, delays thought to be connected to the ongoing might have scuppered publisher EA's plans. Hey, you learn a new word every day. I have no idea what scuppered means.
Scuppered. To defeat or put an end to.
Pushing back the release, but a source that claims to have intel on the project insists, I know it's real. Up until, like, this last week, I know the plan for sure was to announce it in early October, release in late October. So, good news, revealed GamesBeat journalist Jeff Grubb on a recent podcast, thank you to VGC. Maybe bad news, it is 2020. Maybe that could start to slip. It sounds like maybe that's a possibility. Nothing for sure yet.
I quit. I'm done with this job.
My God, man, like, all I want is a Mass Effect Trilogy Remaster. Why is this, like, why is every remaster I want in my lifetime something I've really, really gotta fight for? Like, I still haven't seen Knights of the Old Republic come back, BioWare. Don't think I forgot that amidst all of my excitement for Mass Effect. I want my Matty games to come back, okay? I want them to come back. I know it's real, he later insisted. I've seen more than enough evidence to know it's real. But it's still 2020, and they haven't announced it yet. This is something I talked about in my BioWare Dragon Age 4 reveal. I'm excited for Dragon Age 4, believe it or not, although that's a little bit naive of me because of Anthem and Andromeda, as well as some of my lingering thoughts on Inquisition. But still, I'm excited for BioWare to bounce back as one of my favorite developers when I was growing up, and I hope the best for them. However, I thought it was strange for them to preemptively announce Dragon Age 4 with a behind-the-scenes trailer and not talk about the game that's clearly coming out at least within the next number of months. So yeah, I don't know why they haven't brought it out yet. Obviously, at Gamescom, that would have been a great time to say, hey, we have this Mass Effect Trilogy Remaster coming, especially with some of the later information that we're gonna get into. I feel like that just was an ideal time to say this is indeed happening, especially because it's leaked everywhere. People were able to pre-order it at one point in time. It's been confirmed by a number of insiders. So I don't know if EA and BioWare are just less confident that this game's actually going to make it out this year because of something happening behind the scenes. But as it stands, things should still happen, so let's keep reading. I think EA were planning to have this Mass Effect trilogy be the other big thing other than Star Wars Squadrons for $60 this holiday. So that's why I'm still pretty confident it'll make it out, Grubb added. But with everything else falling apart, like across the board, I could see them also wanting to just delay. But that's not for sure. That's not a guarantee yet. Like, that hasn't even been decided yet. It just seems like a possibility that's on the table, but last I heard, October for both. So yeah, I understand why they want to do a double release this holiday period, which is why, once again, Mass Effect truly makes sense. They want to go ahead and double up because Star Wars Squadrons, believe it or not, is looking to be not monetized at all. Whatsoever. No live service elements, They're also not doing DLC, though, so if you really like the game, what you see is what you get, but it's sort of an ode to what I'd say is what we expected from games many, many years ago. You buy it, that's it. Maybe they patch a couple of things after launch, but other than that, it is just a finished product coming out, or their version of finished. But because of that, because of the lack of live service elements, only the upfront sales are going to make EA money. So they either need to have another live service game. And I know Madden's certainly not going to be that this year. Oh boy. So in comes the Mass Effect Trilogy Remaster, a brand with a ton of weight that doesn't need to really market itself at all other than just saying, I exist, come buy me. And I think that EA will go through with it, because if they're going to release Madden the way they did, I'm just going to say, man, I have pretty good confidence that the Mass Effect Trilogy Remaster will come out this year. And for all intents and purposes, it is realistic to say that a delay is forever on the table this year because of the conditions that developers have to work through. Obviously, most of them working from home, it makes things tricky. It makes things different, from communication to overall coordination of a project and generally getting access to the builds that they had in the office from home. There's just so many hurdles to go through, and it's a challenge for all these different studios, so it can lead to some setbacks. However, it is just like I had been saying, according to Jeff, that the same month that we're going to hear about the game is also the same month it's going to release. A lot of people have been saying they don't believe that, so if it does happen this year, well, I get to have my I told you so moment. It's one of the best feelings when you're a content creator. I love it. The article wraps up saying, interestingly, Grubb also advised fans to expect an upgraded version rather than full remakes of the sci-fi adventures. I don't know that for sure. I would probably lean towards upgrade. I think when I asked around about this, that was kind of the vibe I was getting. And I think that's what people should expect for sure. So this one may come across as a disappointment, which is why I said, I don't know if this is good news or bad news, right? Now the release date is sort of up in the air. Now it's not a remake of at least one, right? Most people, I think, wanted to have the Mass Effect series intact, but most notably was remaking parts of one where it felt more current, and of course the ending of three, having that be reconstructed. I think that in its own right could be considered a upgrade, and I think that would be super exciting as a Mass Effect fan, because that would get me through the whole trilogy again, right? Nostalgia can always carry you so far, but when you know that there's a new ending, I mean, man, I'm in, right? Like, I will go through the whole ride once more to see what BioWare has cooked up. And I think that would be one of the most interesting things for them to address. When it comes to Mass Effect 1, it is such a classic, but it does feel old. It doesn't feel all that great. So if they've got to go into the system and change how some of the guns play, how some of the cover shooting works, I think that can overall bring Mass Effect 1 to a better level. But you can't get rid of things like some planets feeling really empty, some of the things that we actually saw in Andromeda, funny enough. But you can't get rid of some of the features that were already baked into the product. I just hope it's not like a standard resolution and frame rate upgrade, because what Jeff mentioned here that could easily fly under the radar of a lot of people is that it's a $60 price tag. Now, this is a remaster, and we have certainly seen larger packages, equal of size packages, come out for cheaper. And I know the Mass Effect brand carries a lot of weight. I know it's very exciting, and I know it's been a while. But for example, if they're like, it's 1, 2, 3, we don't have 3's multiplayer, and it's just an up-res with a frame rate change, to me, like, do I say it's not worth $60? It's like, if you've never played Mass Effect, it certainly is. But going back to it, that seems like you're really cutting a lot out of what made the entire package, and then just adding some new bells and whistles and saying, yep, $60, when that should be something along the lines of like a $40 package. So I'm still really excited for the Mass Effect Trilogy Remaster, don't get me wrong, but this set of news leveled me out, right? Like, I was full steam ahead, get me in there, like, I'm really excited, I'm still very excited, but now expectations have been, you know, tempered a little bit. So it's gonna be more along the lines of a upgrade rather than a remake, which I think it was sort of foolish to ever expect that. I never really was in that camp of expecting a full-on remake of each of the games. I think that that would have just led to a lot of trouble, and it would have brought about its own set of issues, and we would have had what's kind of happening with Lego Star Wars: The Skywalker Saga, where, I mean, that's an incredible game, right? Like, that, what they're doing with that series is actually really, really cool. Pretty much making 9 full Lego games, right? Like, they used to sell them in little trilogies, and now it's going to be all of them, and they've all been, like, touched up and changed completely. That in its own right is really exciting, but there's a reason why that game's been getting delayed a lot, right? It's a huge project, and think of Mass Effect, where it's an RPG with branching story paths and stuff, so it'd be kind of off the wall. So I feel like it's smarter just to upgrade things, and if they add some new features to 1, maybe they twist up what happens at the end of 3. That would be enough to satisfy me. Also, bring back that damn multiplayer. But with that, ladies and gentlemen, that's our latest update here on the Mass Effect Trilogy Remaster. So it's still looking like it's locked in for October, but things are up in the air because it's 2020, of course. Furthermore, it's looking more like an upgrade rather than a remake. So what do you think of all this brand new information? Let me know in the comments down below. Other than that, follow me on Twitter, follow me on Instagram. Those links are in the description down below. Big thank you to all the patrons who continue to push the limits of our content. Stay sexy, stay active. I love you all. Peace.